And prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive. keep you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said, like Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on, you know him and have seen him. 14, 1 through 7, receive this blessed word and you will be blessed. It's catching. Catch your neighbor, say it's catching.
I want to do something. We're going to ask Mother Perkett, Mother McKinney. Amen. We're going to ask you to come. And we just want to have a special prayer.
Yes.
Amen. Come. Amen. The Lord is going to deliver and set free on this morning. And we just need a special prayer.
Yes.
Amen. That God may touch and deliver.
That you would touch,
heal,
and deliver.
In the name of Jesus.
Heal the wounded spirit.
Heal, God.
Heal the broken heart.
In the name of Jesus.
Heal, oh God. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
We're calling on you right now.
Yes, sir.
With all the free today. Comfort and give strength,
oh God.
In the name of Jesus. Look unto Mary and her
little son.
Comfort her heart this
morning.
In the name of Jesus.
Heal, Lord.
Heal the wounded.
Heal, oh God.
Heal the broken heart.
Heal, oh God.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. In Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. In your name.
Oh God. We look to you all today.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh God. Brother Benny, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
Heal, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Touch his family, oh God.
Yes.
Comfort their hearts, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Speak to every need,
every
Lord.
Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Lord. You say in all things give thanks, and we thank you. You are the God of all God. You are a merciful God. You are comforter. You are strength. Strength today, God. New hope today, God. New hope in you, God. Lift the burdens, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus. You there in the presence right now, God. Touches only you can do, God. New hope, Lord. New hope, God. In the name of Jesus. Lift the burdens, oh God. Let them cry to you as never before. Comfort in every direction, oh God. The sick and the shut in everywhere, God. The God of all comfort. Only you can do it, oh God. We're looking to you today, God. A joyful testimony. It's in you we live and have our being. Lord, we thank you. You know, God. You know what's best for us, oh God. Comfort, oh God. Joy in the midst of everything that's not like you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Touch the sick everywhere. Touch at the hospital. Touch at the nursing home. Touch, oh God. Touch and deliver today, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Give new life, God. New life, God. New life, God. In the name of Jesus. Touch everyone. Touch the elders. Touch our pastor, God. Oh, God. Strengthen everyone, oh, God. And we'll give you praise. We'll give you the honor. We will bless your holy name. You are worthy of the praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we thank you. Thank you. In Jesus' name.
So good. Bible.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Please remain standing as we do our vision, our pledge, our purpose, and our motto. Our vision. Our pledge.
We pledge to give life to those who are lost and without hope of eternal life.
Our purpose.
To impact our community by demonstrating God's presence, God's love, and God's word in our everyday lives.
And our motto.
Rescue in the parish.
Things happen in our lives, yes, that I never forget when my husband left here, and I didn't think that it was that was the end, because we knew the Lord had let us know that it was his time. But we don't ever want it to happen with our loved ones, but it happens. And then we say, we will bless the Lord at all times. And as long as we are here, as long as we know the Lord, we have a job to do. We have a job to let the world know we're going to bless the Lord at all times. We're going to obey the self-examination our lesson told us this morning. Will I? That's what the word was saying this morning. Take yourself and examine. Are you going to obey the word? Are you going to obey the word? It's telling us what to do, to how to be really be blessed. I've been thinking of the song, brother, what's your name? Brother Roy. I'm on the battlefield for my, we got a work to do. Oh, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I promise him that I did promise.
Thank you. but my faith is not shaken. So because of my faith not shaking, I know the blood still works. The blood still works. Tuesdays we fast until 4 p.m., 7 p.m. choir rehearsal. Wednesday we have prayer at 6 a.m. And if you on there, you will know what I'm saying. The blood still works. Even through my sister's circumstances right now, the blood still works. And prayer is at, Wednesday service is at 7 p.m. We fast until 4 p.m. and then we have prayer here at noon. The 112 Holy Convocation this week is Sunday. See, the devil was really working on me, but guess what? He's a liar. So, Sunday school. Friendly Temple Church of God in Christ will be in there past the anniversary for Bishop Edwin Walker today at 4 p.m. All those who would like to attend with our Pastor Perkhead are welcome to attend. The program is on the back of the address is on the back of the program. They're also will be celebrating him with a banquet on November 22nd. The tickets are $125. And you can see Pastor Perkett for more information. Thanksgiving, if you would like to donate towards Thanksgiving, our Thanksgiving, please see Sister Bertha Waddy on or before November 17th. New Mission Church setup meeting will be Wednesday, November 20th at 7 p.m. If you are a minister, missionary or auxiliary leader, please plan to attend. New Mission Temple men's meeting is Saturday, November 23rd at 10 a.m. Please see Sister Elder LaVince and Terry for more information. Annual Thanksgiving service is Wednesday, November 27th at 7:15 p.m. Our prayer request is Elder James Allen, Sister Mary Ann Baker, Brother Christopher Baldwin, Sister Tanetta Brown, Brother Bobby Jackson, Sister Rosie Perkhead, Mother Evelina Terry, Minister Darrell Werlow, Missionary Katrina Werlow, Deacon Benny Williams, the afflicted, the bereaved families, and the shut-in seniors. Widows, married couples, families, singles, youth, the church, government leaders, our troops, and our nation, the peace of Jerusalem. Our November birthdays. Brother Tim Hatton, Sister Tanessa Brown, Super Tim Widow. Woodrow Hinton, Sister Sonia Smith, Sister Ashley Starling. Devil, you're not going to win today. You're not. Sister Angela Terry and Sister Tamika Berger. Please remember, if you have any announcements, to put them in the Sunday bulletin board. Please come help Judah praise, minister, and dance as we give God praise for being ordinary Jesus at Second Faith Temple Church of God in Christ. That will be Sunday, November 24th at 6 p.m. as we celebrate Week of Praise and Thanksgiving. November 25th, 26th, and 27th, nightly at 8 p.m. and November 28th from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. All funds go to our outreach ministry.
Glory be to God, guys. Glory be to God. I just have two extra announcements to add. I forgot to get it into Missionary Judy. Missionary Warlow wanted me to go forward and helping her with planning the YWCC Love Service for February coming up in 2020. We had an awesome time this year, and we want to make sure we have another glorious time in the coming year. So we want to start raising dues for that event. Starting today, each month, November, December, January, we can start giving $10 members and church members. That would be great so that we can have a nice offering for the YWCC Love Service. And with the Thanksgiving for this year, me and Missionary Martin is trying to get 10 nice gift bags with the gift cards inside. For those that need extra support for Thanksgiving, please see me after church today so that I can put your names down and me and Mother Martin can present it, and you'll have your gift basket on November 17th. Thank you.
Be destroyed. He asks a question. What do the righteous do? Now we know that they're not destroyed. I'm going to get the offering, but I'm processing. We know that they're not destroyed because the foundation is sure. But he says, if the foundations be destroyed, what do you do? He tells us that the Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his eyelids try the children of men. So that tells me that to who I go to and where I go to. We go to the Lord who is in heaven. The heavens are high above where he dwells. And it tells us that he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow, even in the challenging times. So the answer to the question is that where do the righteous go? We go where the Lord is. We go to where the throne of the Lord is, and that is in heaven. And we cry out to him from the depths of our pain and struggle, as we do today. Heavenly Father, I am thankful for who you are. I'm thankful that you are far above all of our troubles and challenges. God, I thank you for the peace that passes understanding, even in the midst of all of them. Oh, God, we come boldly to your throne, God, in the time of need, looking for mercy and grace to make it through this period. Oh, God, help us today as your people, God, that you have invited us access to the very throne room of God. And here we come, God, boldly, God, with confidence, knowing that you will, oh God, comfort the hearts of the people that are struggling even right now. We know the foundations are not destroyed because they are built upon you. And there's none like you nowhere. And we thank you, God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Glory to God. is good.
Yes, he is.
My children, line up. Peter, I'm going to raise your hands. You need to use a swipe to see me at the back. Gracious God and Father, we thank you for this, again for this opportunity to share into this ministry. God, we ask that you would bless every giver, every supporter, and that you would give back 40, 60, 100-fold in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, God. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Give and he'll give it back to you. Give and he'll give it back to you. Give and he'll give it back to you. Press down, shaken together, running over, and full of good measures. That's what he'll give to you. You want to give, then he'll give it back to you. Come on and give, and he'll give it back to you. Give, and he'll give it back to you.
How the mission?
You give and he'll give it back to you. Give and he'll give it back to you.
How?
Shaking together, running over, and full of good measures. That's what he'll give to you. You want to give and he'll give it back to you. Come on, give and he'll give it back to you. Give and he'll give it back to you.
How the mission?
are the source of our strength. And I lift my hands. Come on, somebody, lift your hands and worship. Come on, begin to worship the Lord.
Come on, now let your preacher
somebody is on right now. Come on, tell somebody else. God told me to tell you. It's all right now. Hallelujah. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. Something about praise that will alleviate your problem, that will lift your burdens, and cause sunshine to come in a dark place. I dare somebody just to begin to tell the Lord, Lord, I thank you. Come on, somebody, open up your mouth and tell the Lord, I thank you. Why am I thanking you? Because it's all right now. It's all right now. All right, y'all just say that if you want to. Myra Clay. We don't understand, but God has a plan. Amen. It's hard sometimes to say yes to the Lord. Amen. It's a hard thing, especially when your heart is so fixed. It's a hard thing to say yes to the Lord. But today I say yes, God. In your sovereign, I say yes, Lord. God is the only one that's sovereign. He's the only one that's sovereign. So we say yes to him. We don't understand why. I want to be a multimillionaire. Amen. I would love to be able to just do what I want, when I want, how I want. But see, I probably wouldn't come to church like I want to. Like I need to. I don't know. I might be on the island of Ruba Ruba. If I have money to do what I want to do, when I want it, how I want. But see, right now, I'm at a place now where I need to give God some praise. Because he is all that I have. My hope is not built on nothing less but what? Jesus Christ. I wish I had somebody on today. My hope is not built on nothing than Jesus Christ and his righteousness. Amen. So I have no, because I don't have $1 million in the bank. So I come to the house of the Lord because I trust him for everything that I need.
Amen.
Janice, I trust him for everything that I need. Amen. He will supply all of our needs. Amen. So we thank God today. Amen. I know how you feel. This is a time of really just really saying, God, I trust you. I trust you for our sister. But it's going to be all right. God bless you, everybody. I had a sermon today, and I'm not going to talk about that. But there was a sermon, and I listen all the time to different preachers throughout the week, because I just want to hear. I want to hear what thus saith the Lord. But Bishop Alston preached a message not too long ago. Why? And I think the scripture that he used on that day, I'm not copying, but I think the scripture that he used on that day would be appropriate for this matter. So, sometimes all of us ask the Lord, why? Why? Anybody ever ask the Lord why? If you haven't, you will. There's many times when I say, Lord, how did that happen? Why am I going through this? And there was a number of scriptures. There was one scripture that he used. It's Exodus, the 5th chapter. It spoke to my heart this morning. The 5th chapter. The 20th verse. Exodus, the 5th chapter. Like I said, you may not understand everything, but in all things, there's purpose. God has purpose for us. I got to be careful what I say, because that thing is on. I wish we could cut it off. Amen. So that we can hear, you know.